Hey, Stroke Lines. Someone wrote me the other day, and they were having a problem sending some keys, characters, with the send command. And what they were also trying to do is they were trying to combine it with something else. This isn't quite actually what they ended up, what they were actually trying to do. They were trying to do something else, but this is the code. This is close to the code they gave me. And then I'll get into the second version. But what I wanted to demonstrate and to discuss here is the whole sending of the clipboard, and it's just I agree, it's not that it's wrong, right? There's just there's more than one way to do things in AutoHotkey, right? So right now we're storing the clipboard here, we have these characters on it, and then we're going to send hello and then the clipboard after, right? So when I run this, you're going to see it actually it sends little, it loses a lot of characters. It actually tried to restart OBS, because what's happening is it's sending some of these shit, like the plus is a shift key, the exclamation point, which actually I guess I had taken out, okay, it sends those, and it's sending them as keys, and so that's part of the issue of why you're having a problem. One way you could fix it, a simple way, is we could say send raw, and that theoretically, I think, save it, I'm going to relaunch it, and now when I run it, so now it sends the raw characters, right? So that's an easy, quick fix. It's one way to do it. However, depending on how long the text is that you're sending and what you're doing with it, I would recommend going a different route. And what I did, let me get rid of this. You know what? Let me keep that and I'll just comment it out. So get rid of that. Get rid of this. And let me bring this up here. This is what I ended up writing for him, because what he wanted after he told me the first part of, because at first I got rid of the clipboard. I said, I don't understand why you're using the clipboard. It's not really necessary. But what he was doing was he wanted to highlight something, double click, you know, highlight the text, hit a hotkey or type something and have it append the copy of the text that's selected, prepend, I should say, it to the clipboard. And then send it. And so what I did was I said, okay, let's use it where it's Control T. We're going to back up the clipboard. This is a nice thing you can do on a hotkey. So I don't lose what's in the clipboard, right? So I don't replace it. And this way it doesn't mess with my, obviously it does. But at the end of it, you have the clipboard restored again down here on line 25. So I'm going to store the clipboard. You want to store all, because that'll keep all the RTF and everything else. If you don't do that, it'll just store just the text. I'm going to send event, send the Control C. So this is where whatever is highlighted, it's going to send Control C to copy. Then I'm going to use the clip wait function. The nice thing about this, you could just do it and hope that what's in there got on the clipboard. But the clip wait is a great function that says, hey, wait up to however many seconds are here. So we're going to wait up to 1 second for the clipboard to have some data in it. That's also why right here I blanked it out. So it's an important step. So first you blank out the clipboard. First I back up the clipboard and then I clear it out. I actually could have done that in one line, I think, if I really wanted to. I could put those in the same line if we care. But and then I send Control C and I say, hey, wait until, don't move forward until there's a value in that clipboard. And that just helps take care of some errors. If it doesn't, something doesn't get to the clipboard, what you'll see is it, like if I ran it here, let me hit, I don't know if I ran this, let me hit Control T with nothing selected. So notice it waited a second and then it said, hey, no text was selected, and it's going to hit okay. And because I have this return here, it's not going to keep going, right? So that's some error control. It's a nice thing to build into your scripts. The next thing, so after it does that, it's going to take whatever's in the clipboard and prepend the word. In this case, the example he gave me, I'm not sure what he's doing, but he wanted to put the word hello with a space. So this will do that. And then this is the key, right? This is what's similar to row 4 up here. We're saying send paste. So send paste, not send the keys that are in the clipboard. So up above, we were literally sending one character at a time, like keystrokes, right? Popping them in there. The send paste says, hey, dump what's in the clipboard into the edit screen, right? It's so much faster and more reliable. It's crazy when you actually start doing it, especially, like I said, you get some longer text and man, it's the difference is huge. And then here's another funny one is add a sleep here. I say at least, 50, this is 1/10 of a second. So whatever 50 is to that 1/20th of a second, I suppose. But you want to add a little bit of a sleep here and then restore the clipboard. So we put the clipboard back into the clipboard. And that way, like let's say if I have the word Joe here. No, that's a bad example. Because I'm going to highlight that. You know what? Let's do this. I'm going to cut that. Let's open Studio. First, let me launch this again. Make sure it's running. All right. So in Studio, or sorry, Site. Wow, this works. Joe. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this, copy it, and now if I paste, you'll see it has Wildest Joe. This works in the clipboard. Now I'm going to double click here and hit Control T. So it took out the Joe and put Hello Joe, whatever was selected, it's going to take it out, put Hello in the beginning, and then send both of them because it appended them together. But look at this. Watch when I hit paste here. Right, I still have my original clipboard, and that's the beauty of this part of it. Right, is I love doing this because you can do stuff, back up your clipboard, do stuff with it, and then pull it back in, and it doesn't matter. You didn't lose the stuff in your clipboard. It's really nice to build a little tool like that, and you still have your clipboard. The other one, which by the way, you know, you can do is the Windows V. Don't forget Windows V on Windows 10 shows you your history of the clipboard. Right, and you can go back and you make stickies. I have a video on that, but check it out. It is nice to have that. But just wanted to clarify the difference between, you know, sending, send raw, and then sending the quote-unquote clipboard as characters versus sending paste. And sending paste is, in a lot of ways, far superior. All right, thanks.